All right, so I've had a lot of people asking me how I make my dog's food. I've only just started doing this, and it's actually not rocket science, and it takes about an hour once every 5 days, and that's to feed two of my dogs. One's about 75 pounds, one's 42, 43 pounds. And they're eating quite a bit, so honestly, it's not that hard, and it feels good to know I'm giving them the best. I had to make a batch tonight, so I'm like, why not make a video so everyone can see exactly how I do this? It's really not hard. So, first thing you want to do is cook up your grains and plant protein. So, I've got a pot here. I already cooked up 2 cups of whole grain brown rice. And 2 cups of lentils, brown lentils, really high in fiber and protein. You can see there's some pink in the pot. I cooked a big giant batch of beets in this pot, and the pot I made the rice in wasn't big enough to add everything else, so I just transferred to this pot. So that's already cooked up very soft. You want it to be very, very soft so it's almost mushy. And then once that's cooked, you're going to add in your meats. This is something I thought I would never do again, but for my dogs, I'm buying meat. Really hate it, but it's the best thing for my dog who has cancer. Dogs can thrive on a vegan diet, but dogs with cancer need to avoid sugars, so hence we need to do more meat. So I got beef this time. This is the first time I've done beef. I mix it up every time. Sometimes it's chicken. Usually I have some liver, which is really good for them. Disgusting meat, but really good for them. I don't have that. I had one fillet of salmon left from like a multi-pack in the freezer. So this is what is going in today. It's just over 1 kilo of beef and just one large salmon fillet. I cut it up into little tiny pieces. And then once your rice and lentil mixture is cooked, you can add in the meat. I also like to add in some different herbs and spices, not only to cover up the smell of the meat, but just because it's good for them. Parsley is really good for them. Cumin, it's good and it also makes it have a great smell. And turmeric, you can be generous, like a tablespoon, maybe two. I never measure, I just throw it in there. Of your spices. You can add that in while the meat's cooking in there, so I'm going to do that as my next step. And then while that's simmering, I'm going to prepare all my veggies and my add-ins. So, a good thing to have is some sort of cruciferous vegetables. I'm going to do broccoli. It was on sale this week. I just get whatever's on sale, whatever I can find at a good price. Bell peppers are very good for them. Red, yellow, orange, very good. Orange vegetables like carrots, squash, sweet potatoes. I have to keep Blues fairly low sugar because he has cancer. Cancer cells feed on sugar, so he needs a little bit different nutrients than other dogs that are healthy, so he won't get as much of that. Some nice apples. There's the package of lentils that I have there. And then I'm going to add in some mushrooms and beets. I cooked up a bunch of beets, so why not add that in? Another thing you can use for your plant proteins is whole oats, steel-cut oats. You don't want to get the quick oats, you want to get like the whole flake ones. And then I add in a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. Now, some of these other ingredients you see are things that I add in as food additives after the fact. So when I'm giving them their food, I'll be adding in nutritional yeast, good source of B12, gives it a cheesy flavor. I add in the morning some minced garlic, just like a nice sort of a loony size, and then chop that up. Fresh minced garlic, one small clove added in every day. This white powder, this is calcium citrate. You can add cottage cheese as an option for calcium, but I don't have cottage cheese, so I got calcium citrate tablets. Just make sure they're pure calcium citrate. That's that there. Good for bone health, especially for a dog with bone cancer. I add in with his dinner one glucosamine pill just for his joints because he's a larger dog, so his hips obviously are going to be more stressed. You can add it in raw or you can add it in when it's cooking. I like to add it in just at the end of cooking so it steams, but kale or spinach, really good for them as well. Good for us, good for them. Powerhouse of nutrients. I drizzle on some olive oil or some coconut oil every meal as well. And then sometimes as a treat or with his meal, I'll give them each a half of a sardine. This is just in water. You can get in oil or in water. It's good for them for omega-3s. So this is pretty much what you need to add in. Another good thing that you can add here that I have is flax seeds, and I also have sunflower seeds. Now what I do with those is I put them in the blender so that it makes like a powder so that it's ground up nice for them. So that's a blend of the flax and the sunflower. I just add a scoop of that on top of the breakfast every day. So that's it. It seems like a lot, but honestly, when you're doing it, it takes literally like an hour, and then I have a giant Tupperware and it lasts me for like 5 days. They love the food, and honestly, I feel great about giving them this instead of just dry kibble. It's even the expensive stuff, it's not whole food nutrients. It doesn't have living enzymes. It doesn't have everything that they need. It doesn't have a variety. So every week they get a little bit of something different. Next week I might not have a red pepper. I might not have beets. I might have spinach instead. I might have cauliflower. Who knows? So it changes up every week, but honestly, they're loving it, and it gives me great joy to see them enjoy their food so much. I hope this helps anyone who's had questions. Sorry if I rambled on, but there's a lot kind of that goes in there, and there's reasons why it's all in there. So yeah, if you have any questions, you can write in the comments or send me a message. I'd be happy to help. Like I said, I'm still learning, so I don't know everything about this. If you have any advice for me or things that I might be missing, please do tell me. Like I said, I've only started this in this last month, so any help that you might have, I appreciate. Thanks a lot, guys. I hope you start cooking for your dogs, even if it's just half and half, half kibble, half fresh food. I think you're going to love it as much as I do and as much as my dogs love their food. Thanks. Bye.